Welcome to the advanced section of the Changing Accounting Systems video course. Now we're doing the advanced level of setup. It's actually easier than some of the things that we've already done in the course. They're only called advanced level steps because they involve something called workarounds. A workaround is using the software differently than usual, and this is to account for something that's simply not available in the software. Advanced topics need an equity type of account to balance the accounts before the main setup journal entry. All of these advanced steps must be done before the main setup journal entry. In this specific video, we will be addressing the last part of the undeposited funds setup. This specific condition, invoice payments that are applied to closed invoices. It's very rare that invoice payments that have already been applied to closed invoices will be sitting in undeposited funds on the day of setup. It's the only detailed part of the setup, and it's the only part that's non-intuitive. It's the only part that really needs special steps to set up. Now, we do not have this condition when changing over to the Advanced QuickBooks Online course. This is just a general example, just to make you aware of the steps if you ever have this condition when you're changing over from one accounting system to another. In a previous video, we already discussed how we split payments that are sitting in undeposited funds if some of the payment was applied to a currently open invoice and the rest of the payment was applied to an invoice that was already closed. If the payments have been completely applied to a currently open invoice, then we enter them as part of the receivable setup, just like we did in a prior video. And if the payment is completely applied to a closed invoice, then we enter them after the receivable setup, the way I'm about to show you. However, we should take a brief moment and discuss payments that are still in undeposited funds that are applied to both closed invoices and open invoices. Well, what would you do with a payment that was applied to both open and closed invoices as of the transfer date? The instructions say you would have to enter them as two separate payments. You would have to enter both of them with the same date, the same check number, but the only difference is they would be two separate money amounts. So don't be scared or intimidated or confused. It's the same payment. You simply entered it twice with two different money amounts. One money amount will be the piece of the payment that has been applied to the currently open invoice, and that would be entered with all the other applied payments when you do your accounts receivable setup. Then you would enter the piece of the payment that is not applied to any currently open invoice with the other unapplied payments, which is what I'm about to show you now. In other words, everything above the line you enter during the accounts receivable setup, and everything below the line you enter exactly as I'm about to show you now. Now, after we create a dummy customer in the customer center, we record the payments that have been applied to closed invoices, using that dummy customer. Now, we do not apply them to any of the invoices. We must leave them as an open credit. Do not destroy the correct balances in accounts receivable. Do not change any of the invoices. For example, let's imagine on the transfer date, there were two additional payments in undeposited funds that were already applied to invoices that have been closed as of, closed or paid off as of the transfer date. So, for example, on March 1 of 2017, the year we were working with, We received check number 772 from Alan for $500. And on March 13th, we received check 883 from Betty for $600. We have to use the dummy customer instead of Alan and Betty. So that's very simple. Here we are back in QuickBooks Online, and we click Sales, Customers, and now we can click New Customer. And all you have to do is type the word dummy. You don't have to use the word dummy, but it's a dummy customer because you're not really using it. You're not really using it in real life. You're using it just as a workaround. So now you have your dummy customer. And if I click here, you see dummy customer is on the list. Now let's enter the March 12th check for $772 for Alan for $500 and do not apply it to an invoice. But again, we're not going to choose Alan. We're going to choose the dummy customer. So very simple. We go to the plus sign and we click receive payment and we choose the dummy. And we make sure that the date, let me just come here. Let me make sure that the date is March 12 of 2017. Now the instructions say we received check 772 for $500. No problem. So we put check, well, payment method, we put check, and then we put 772, and the amount is $500. Now that's now we click save and close, and we save it as a credit in the dummy customer. Then on March 13th, we had another one we put in the dummy customer. What's that? That's check 883 for $600. So it's check 883 for $600. And that's all you have to do to record them. Save as a credit. Now what we have is a dummy customer who has a credit balance of $1,100. Now, again, we did not apply to an invoice. We left it as an open credit. Now, we're going to make an accounts receivable adjustment in the journal entries window. And this is usually done by an accountant user. And we will use the equity type of account because for advanced portions of the conversion of one system to another, equity accounts are the ones used to balance everything out. Now, in this case, it is correct in accounting theory to do this. That's because these payments are for income in the past that has been or will be closed to an equity account as per normal accounting procedures. So don't worry about the balance of the equity account. Owner's equity will be corrected when we make our final journal entry setup. Right now, our goal is simply to make sure that the balance in accounts receivable is correct and the equity account will correct itself later. So we have to wipe out this dummy balance of the negative 1,100. How do we do that? Click the plus sign and we go to journal entry. And of course, the journal entry should really be the date of conversion. And the account we're going to adjust, now watch this carefully, the account we're going to adjust is accounts receivable. But if you're using accounts receivable or accounts payable in a journal entry, you are required to choose the specific customer that goes along with the change in accounts receivable. By choosing the specific customer, you're keeping the subsidiary customer balances equal to the total in the account in the chart of accounts, accounts receivable. And because this dummy already has a credit balance, we have to debit accounts receivable to wipe out the credit balance. And the balancing entry goes to either, well, now you have a choice with your equity accounts. I'm going to use opening balance equity, but you could use the owner's capital. No matter what, it would have to be an equity type of account. Now when we click save, we will go back to the trial balance and see that accounts receivable. See, look at the dummy. The dummy now has a zero balance. And if we click reports, trial balance, we see that accounts receivable is now back to the corrected number, and the only number that changed is opening balance equity. And that's going to be fixed anyway in the end when we make our final adjustment journal entry setup.